like the still rooms here. Yeah.
No, we're happy to hear.
The range of mountains sort of to the north of us in Burrell Pine Mountain National Park caught fire from a lightning strike that had started in New South Wales, and then that came over those mountains and then spotted all across the valley here and then kept moving at great pace. So we had fire fronts coming at all sorts of angles and the whole valley basically was impacted by the fire through that night.
When I got here, it was already alight. And these hills back behind us there were all going. I chased it up there and looked over and it had gone kilometres ahead.
Not a very happy night for anybody, but luckily nobody was actually badly injured or anything like that.
It's not like any normal fire. A normal fire might take two or three properties. This just took an entire district. You know, I think 57% of the farming land in the district was burnt, and that's a huge loss.
Beautiful looking place and nice and green and all of that. Don't be fooled by that there is still an awful lot of work to do. And because of the shape of our valleys and everything, you know, potentially you have isolation issues and they all need to be dealt into whatever legislative structure gets put in place to try and support communities in these regional and rural remote areas.
People want to get active straight after a disaster. You know, how do they participate in something? It's not easy for many people because they're dealing with their own challenges, but many people recover through being actively involved in the broader community recovery. We hear many, many times, someone else is worse off. And it's that kind of mentality that permeates a whole community such as this. It's a well-established community. Multiple, six, seven generations have grown up here. So it's, there's a deep sense of what community is, and many people want to be part of that. Then on top of that, it's you know, the coming together of people, and that has a direct correlation with mental health and well-being. Social inclusion and coming together gives a sense of not just purpose in what we're doing, but how we're going about it, and being part of that social interaction is really, really important as part of recovery.